We hear you. We have been tracking the words all of you have been using all day about what is going on in Washington. Words like bizarre, sabotage, blackmail, and enough. The president expressed outrage that one faction in one House of Congress is ready to bring the entire federal government to a halt. And here is our shutdown clock counting towards midnight. ABC's chief White House correspondent Jonathan Carl now looks at this shutdown that seems both real and surreal. John?
Diane, I'm told the president just spoke to the Speaker of the House for the first time in more than a week, but no breakthrough. We are headed toward a shutdown.
With a shutdown now all but certain, the president issued a warning.
A shutdown will have a very real economic impact on real people. It would throw a wrench into the gears of our economy at a time when those gears have gained some traction.
He placed the blame entirely on conservative Republicans in the House who are demanding an end to Obamacare.
One faction of one party in one House of Congress in one branch of government doesn't get to shut down the entire government just to refight the results of an election.
Not everything gets shut down. Troops will continue to be paid. Social Security checks will continue to go out. Medicare and Medicaid benefits, too. And the post office will remain open. But every national park will be shuttered, veteran support centers closed, more than 800,000 federal workers told to stay home without pay. It's Washington dysfunction at its absolute worst. Unreasonable demands, no negotiating, and lots of name-calling.
Blatant extortion.
Their hostage-taking tactics.
Understand we're dealing with anarchists.
And the bill they are arguing about would only fund the government for 6 weeks. House Republicans, who have already voted 46 times to repeal all or parts of Obamacare, are still insisting that they won't fund the government, even temporarily, without at least some change to the law.
It's time for the Senate to listen to the American people and to pass a one-year delay of Obamacare.
It all adds up to a terrible civics lesson for these middle school students from Colorado. They were among the tourists we found today visiting Washington, getting in as many monuments as they can before it all shuts down tomorrow.
I think it's very disappointing to me because it's kind of sending a message that the government cares more about their parties and their bipartisanship than they do us, the American people.
One thing not affected by a shutdown, congressional paychecks. Members of Congress, Diane, just like the president and the vice president, will continue to get paid even during a shutdown.
So they consider themselves essential. Thank you so much, John. And the threat of a government shutdown has already forced Americans to pay a price. The markets were down today. The Dow fell 128 points. And ABC's chief business and economics correspondent Rebecca Jarvis is here to bring this right into the American home. Tell us how much it's going to cost the average American family budget.
It could cost the average American family thousands of dollars, Diane. All of this D.C. dysfunction, we know, comes at a cost for real people, the American people. It creates uncertainty, and economists think it could cost our economy $8 billion a week. Look at the last shutdown. That was 17 years ago. Stocks back then fell 3.7%. If that were to happen today, retirement savings accounts could lose as much as $9,000 in a span of just a couple of weeks, Diane.
But again, the previous experience, it was rather limited, rather short. We're talking about an even bigger threat looming ahead.
Yes, because we have another major battle on the horizon. It's probably something for some that will say crisis fatigue. But for the reality of the situation, we're talking about something that once we faced this before, we faced a credit crisis in this country. Trillions of dollars in wealth wiped out in a matter of a couple of days, a debt downgrade. And that's something that will come October 17th, when we run out of money.
All right. So this is different. This is an even more seismic shift right now. Thank you so much, Rebecca Jarvis.